name is Kunal Doshi, and so I'll be taking your subject of financial management. So before I start the subject, two necessary things. First, what exactly the structure of the subject is, basically kya paper pattern. And the second, that why exactly institute has introduced this particular subject and what is its objective. So we'll first understand that. So if you can tell me what is the basic reason, like, does anyone aspire here to be a businessman? Anyone out here? Or just do job? Probably few of them want to do business, right? Okay. So what is the basic quality required when you start a business? Kya chahiye sabse pehla?
Idea.
Okay. And suppose if you have idea, we all have idea. Either se train pe, ghar pe ja rahe ho, tab tak so idea aata hai. You sit at a restaurant, you get an idea, I should open a restaurant. Right? You get numerous ideas. Don't you start business with those ideas? What stops you?
Finance.
Capital. Suppose you don't have an idea but you have capital. Is that also sufficient? In order to start the business, start a business, you require two forms of capital. One is what you mentioned, idea, your entrepreneurship skill, the zeal that I should start my business. That is called human capital. However, human capital is not sufficient enough. We also require something that we say financial capital. Now that financial capital, where do we get that capital from? How do you first start the business? Kaise start karoge? For example, suppose the easiest business to start is suppose coaching industry. How do people start that with? Do they immediately open up a big class and everything and they do start that? No, right? So what is the basic method through which you start the business? Do you think bank will give you loan? Bank will give you loan? Do you have a company already present? Do you personally have a credit history? Bank loan kaise dega aapne? Bank loan hi nahi dega sabse pehle. Bank would be the last one to give you loan. Then?
Friends
and family. Friends and family, your own savings. Right? Okay. So you take that money and you put in the business. That is one method. The second method, if that is not sufficient, if that is consistently required, then along with that you also involve the other forms of resources, like your friends or family say kya mode pe paisa dete ho, kya different sources hai. That can be in the form of an equity, you give them a partnership stake, or you take a temporary money in form of a debt. So in order to first start the business, what do I require? Different sources of capital. Now are these sources of capital free? Suppose if I take money from friend for free, he will forever give it to me for free? Of course not. If I borrow money from someone, is it going to be free? No. So this capital that you've raised in order to start the business or perhaps continue and grow the business, this capital doesn't come free. So this capital has something that we call as cost. So the first thing that comes into the mind is that what are different sources of fund and how do I raise that funds? So that is where we understand different types of or different sources of funds. Now this types of sources of funds, of course they are not free. So I need to understand what is the cost of these funds. So the major sources of fundraising kya hai sir? Debt and equity. Right? Debt and equity are the two major sources of fund. Of course you have preferential capital also. But let us focus right now on debt and equity. Two major ways of raising money. So this debt and equity, they are of course not free. They do have a cost. And that is what we say, cost of capital. Now, if you have thoda idea, if you invested suppose in my company, why would you invest first of all? Suppose you have invested in my company, will you give me money in the form of debt or equity?
Equity.
Equity? Are you sure?
Yes.
Why?
By purchasing shares.
No. How? Ni? Why?
You will get over the time if the business gets bigger, you can get more
if
return.
The business.
If.
You get more money. Yeah,
more return.
Okay. If it doesn't,
risk.
You have lost everything.
Hmm.
So if you are willing to take more risk, you want equity, right? But if you want conservatively consistent returns,
then
you'll go for debt. So now if I'm raising the company, so now you all answered me from the investor's point of view, right? Suppose you all are my financial consultant, 2 years, 3 years down the line, when you all become chartered accountant, and I ask you that please help me raise money, will you all suggest me debt or equity?
Debt.
Equity.
No, depends तो हर चीज़ का आंसर है इंडिया में. Depends तो हर चीज़ का आंसर है. तुमको कोई 8 लाख 10 लाख depends आंसर देने का तो नहीं देने वाला चार्टर बनने के बाद. After becoming chartered, if you, if a company CFO asks you, how should I raise money, you, you're not gonna say depends, right? He's like, okay, then your job depends. So, you have to now answer me as my company's consultant. How would you want me to raise money? Through debt or through equity? Through debt. When you all invest, you all want me to raise through equity, right? And when you all probably want me to raise money, you all are asking debt. Why? क्या चल रहा है दिमाग में? Fixed amount ही देना है, ज़्यादा नहीं देना है, right? But देना तो है. Equity में तो देना ही नहीं है. Rather I should go for equity, right? Equity तो देना ही नहीं है ना? So, of course, I'm not going to raise entire money from debt. Right, that will be too much of leverage, too much risky. What if I am not able to pay? Neither I'm going to raise entire money through equity. Why? Because debt is relatively cheaper than equity because it has fixed cost. Equity, I'm not comfortable sharing
my profit.
Then the thing is that both have its pros and cons. That is what we'll understand when we understand cost of capital. Whether I should raise the entire money through debt or equity. In reality, what do you think? Companies raise money through debt or equity?
Both.
Combination of both. The richest person in India, perhaps?
Ambani.
He's wealthy enough, right?
Yeah.
Billions of dollars. Even at this point of time, if Reliance Industries has in its book 1,90,000 crore rupees of debt. Of debt. We think, usko kya paise ki zarurat hai? No. It's not that he needs money. It's just that he understands the part that raising money through debt is also at times feasible. So the conclusion is that, should I raise entire money through debt? Should I raise entire money through equity? That, as he rightly said, depends. So let us understand, what exactly does it depend? Who are you and me working for? Only one and one, that is the shareholder. What is our objective of financial management? Our objective of financial management is maximization of wealth of shareholder. तो शेयरहोल्डर के वेल्थ का मैक्सिमाइजेशन डेट से होगा या इक्विटी से होगा, दैट इज व्हाट वी नीड टू एनालाइज बाय अ टॉपिक कॉल्ड कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर. दिस इज द पॉइंट वेरिन यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज द बेस्ट और ऑप्टिमम कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ रेजिंग मनी. सो अंडरस्टैंड दिस केयरफुली. आई एम स्टार्टिंग द बिजनेस. वेयर डू आई गेट द मनी फ्रॉम? सोर्सेज ऑफ कैपिटल. एट व्हाट कॉस्ट शुड आई रेज? कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल. एट व्हाट कॉम्बिनेशन शुड आई रेज? कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर. Now what do I do of this money? You've got the money, right? You have the idea, you have the money. Then?
Yes.
Then kya? Start doing the business. Get to the job. So now what is the dilemma? The dilemma. Of course I have plenty of opportunities. The problem is that plenty of opportunities but limited funds. So where do I put? Again comes the same objective. The place wherein your shareholders' wealth is maximized. Then I have to make a choice whether I should put in project A, project B, project C, whatever. All are profitable, but then I have to think which one gives me highest return for my capital invested. That is analyzed through a topic called capital budgeting. What do we do in capital budgeting? You put money today, right? And tomorrow you get money in the future from that particular project. Whether that is giving you sufficient returns, enough to give your capital providers back or not. That is what we analyze through capital budgeting. But how do I analyze today? I forecast, I estimate how much money I will generate. Now suppose I have forecasted something that I will generate future mein 100 crore cash flow every year. Is there a guarantee of it?
No.
That's where, along with that, I need to inculcate the risk in it. So I do what? Whatever the capital budgeting I do, I inculcate the risk in it through understanding the risk analysis. This will help me understand what is the risk inherent in my projections. This is stage 2. Where do you get the money from? Where do you park your money? How do you use that money? So you have utilized money, you have made profit. What to do of this profit? The company face dilemma that whatever profit or revenue or whatever I have generated money from the business, what do I do of this business? Should I distribute or should I retain? Should I distribute means? Should I give that as dividends or should I keep it in the company without giving dividends? What do you think companies do? Do companies give dividends? Of course they give dividends. Do they give everything that they want as dividends?
No.
is it randomly that I should decide, chalo, let's do a toss, aaj kitna dena hai, ye saal kitna dena hai? A company needs to have a policy of what to do with respect to its earnings. That is where we learn a topic called dividend decision. Now here, when you started the project, started understanding, so you have all the policies at place. Now you start in the project, now you see that project mein jo forecast kiya tha cash flows, whether I'm achieving that or not. But that's where you need to, so is it that I've forecasted and it will happen the same way as I had expected? Of course it will not happen. That's where my business acumen, the way I manage the business, will come to play. And how efficient am I managing the business? That's where I need to focus on small, small things like how am I managing my working capital, my receivables management, my operations, my cash budgeting. This is on a day-to-day basis that I have to focus. This is going to be my everyday job. So overall, where to get the money from, right? What cost and what structure, what combination, where to deploy that money, how is the risk that I need to analyze, what to do with the money that I've earned, whether I should distribute or not, and how do I on a day-to-day basis take care of my operations. This is how business is managed. This is a financial manager's day-to-day job. This is what a CFO's job is. Overall, if you see CFO's job, sources of fund, allocation of fund. Paisa laane ka kidhar se, paisa deploy kidhar karne. But that's where the job doesn't end, right? That's where the job starts. How to efficiently generate that wealth. Whether the company is generating enough wealth for the shareholders or not. Whether the company has performed good or not. How do I analyze that? Suppose the company has this year given 100 crore ka profit. Good, bad?
Good.
Can you conclude?
No.
Good or bad?
No. No.
Of course not. I need to compare that. With what?
Previous year.
Probably last year. Or probably with peers or other companies. That's where I need to assess the performance of the company either through a peer group or either through past year. And that's where I need to assess two things. One is returns and another is risk. So for returns, I assess the performance through ratio analysis. And for risk, how much risk the company is taking, I understand leverages. Everyone. So again, concluding the same thing. Where should I get the money from? What cost and what combination? Where should I deploy the money? How should I, what should I do with that money? Should I distribute or not? I should have that policy at place. How do I efficiently operate my business? And overall, how much am I generating? Am I doing good performance or bad performance with regards to return and risk? This is what your IPC CFM syllabus is.